A pleasant good afternoon. I would like to cordially welcome our representatives on the Ministry of Education, corporate entities, our specially invited guests, our featured speaker, Mrs. Deborah Charbatise Samuel, our esteemed principal, Mr. Denzel Noel, all members of the teaching staff and supporting staff, members of the PTA and the local school board, our parents, the graduating class of 2021, friends and relatives, welcome. My name is Mr. Richard Tudor, and I will be guiding you throughout the procession of the day.
Our graduates shone brightly despite the pandemic and all challenges faced during this time. Please join me as I welcome our shining stars of 2021. Aaliyah Aaron. Akila Weston. Anthony Joseph. Ashley Gomez. Atisha Gomez. Selena Stewart. Shaquilla Baker Williams. Daniel Francis. Darius Vincent. Fidelity George. Franklin Osborne. Jadali Sagar. Joshua Ramnarine. Josiah Riggs. Josiah Teasdale. Kasaya Rampath. Kirby Stewart. Tyrone Jeffrey. Maria Lafourcade. Mark Mohammed. Alicia Pierre. Shakel Gidari. Tyrell Stephen. And Victoria Belis.
Thank you. praise the Lord. I want to say a pleasant good afternoon to each and everyone, to the principal, teachers, Mr. Chairman, and most of all, our graduates this evening. Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. We want to give God thanks and praise for bringing this strength through these 5 years where they had meet to the junction of a new journey. And then this evening I asked to pray for them, so I really want to pray for them. Father and God, I give you praise, I give you honor, and I give you glory this evening, Father. I pray that you will bless everything that has to done in this graduation this afternoon, Father God. We thank you, O Lord God, for the teachers, Almighty God, who have spent all those years with this strength. We thank you for the parents, we thank you for the principal, and most of all, we thank you for every boy and for every girl here this evening, Father. We ask that your blessings be upon them this evening, Father. And God, you will, oh God, you will direct their steps into their new journey, Father. Your word declare, God, you have a good plan for us, and I pray your good plan upon every one of these boys, every one of these girls this afternoon that is graduating, Father, that you have a good plan to prosper them and to give them an expected end this evening, Father. Father, we thank you this evening, Father, oh God. We give you the praise, we give you the honor, we give you the glory, and we declare, oh God, that these children, my God, will have good success. They will have, oh God, what you desire for them, Father. God, you're going to lead them in the path that you have for them, Father God. You will order these children's steps, Almighty God, in your way and in what you desire for them. Father, you have a good plan for every one of them this evening, Father. I declare that the plan that you have for them, Jesus, will be expanded in their life, Almighty God. I pray, oh God, everything that has to be done this evening, Father, you will get the honor, you will get the glory, in Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Good day, students of the graduating class of 2021 of the Guaygari Secondary School. My name is Wendell Perez, and I'm the counselor for the electoral district of Miaro Guaygari. I am honored to be given an opportunity to say a few words to you, because students, you are indeed a light that is shining through the darkness. You have been exposed to a situation whereby no other student in the history of Trinidad and Tobago have faced. You have gotten through something that no one in this lifetime has ever faced. And to be here today on this path to successfully come to a close of your secondary school year, you are indeed a light that is shining through the darkness. We are faced globally with a pandemic that has affected every single aspect of life. You have gone through something that no other student in the history of Trinidad and Tobago has gone through, an entire year without in-person teaching, without that classroom session. And here you are today, graduating class of 2021. So you are indeed heroes that would have done something already that no other person has ever done. I wish to extend congratulations to you on this day and also give a little hint. And one of them is to begin by investing in you. You have already done something that no other person has done before. So you are first. You are from a community, Guaygari, who knows about first. In Trinidad and Tobago, we are termed as a gas economy. The first commercial well was dug in Guaygari. When Columbus came to Trinidad and Tobago in 1492, he came off of the Guaygari Bay. So we know about first. So students, you are indeed a light that is shining through the darkness. And I will be looking at you going forward. Congratulations on this day. And my little advice, as I'm saying to you, is for each and every student here today, After the graduation and the pictures and all that, over the next couple of days, I want to give you a task, and that is for each student to plant 5 coconut trees. Yes, let me say it again. Each student of the graduating class of 2021 to plant 5 coconut trees. So I wish you all the best and all the success going forward. And remember, the journey has now started, and it's up to you to continue making that light shine through that darkness going forward. All the best. Thank you, and have a blessed day.
Good day to all viewers. And thank you for taking the time to join us in celebrating the 2021 graduating class of Guayaguayari Secondary School. I extend a deep and sincere congratulations to each member of the graduating class. Your stay at the school was an achievement. You successfully moved from primary school to secondary school and are now filled with new knowledge and is ready to enter the world of work or pursue post-secondary education. I have not had the good fortune to spend much time with you due to the COVID-19 pandemic and the resulting restrictions to physical schooling. But my interaction with many of you, however brief, have given me hope that you have benefited from an education that will allow you to live long and prosperous life. Among the graduating class, I see potentially great academics, sportsmen, managers, entrepreneurs, and creative and innovative thinkers from whom we at Guayaguayari Secondary School expects great things. Students, believe in yourself and seek to be the best you can be. The graduating class of 2021 have spent most of their schooling at the Form 4 level and all at the Form 5 level in virtual school. This unfortunate situation required students to have access to devices to permit online teaching. In this regard, the school, being duty bound, assisted when it could. Form 5 students were given priority for available devices, and as such, some students benefited from devices provided by EOG Resources, the Trinidad and Tobago Telecommunications Authority, and the National Gas Company. Schooling is more than just academics. It is intended to be holistic, catering to the developmental needs of the student, so that the student can realize his or her fullest potential in adulthood. Positive socialization within the school environment is therefore important. I therefore deduce that over the 5 years, despite the face-to-face restrictions provided by COVID-19, a lot of positive socialization occurred, and each of you will cherish the fun times you had, the friendship, and the teaching and learning that have shaped your life and bring you to this point and set the foundation for your evolving life journey. The graduating class of 2021, just like its predecessors, are ambassadors for the Guayaguayari Secondary School. Your life will be meaningful to your parents, friends, and to us, the staff, teaching and non-teaching, and the generations of Guayaguayari Secondary School students to come. As you have reached this stage in your life and leave as graduates, rest assured that you will be missed. And those that you left behind will forever be supportive of your success. Students, graduates, our Ministry of Education, our school supervisor, Tree, our past principal, Ms. Lynette Alford-Jack, and the staff of Guayaguayari Secondary School wish you all good luck forever. And may what you learned at Guayaguayari Secondary School during your stay here serve you well into the future. Thanks to the Guayaguayari Secondary School PTA and all staff members and contributors for enabling this graduation for a special group of young adults. Thank you, everyone.
I am Alicia Mohaber, the PTA President of Guayaguayari Secondary School. I bring you all greetings on behalf of the PTA. Today, we celebrate with you the graduating class of 2021. As our team says, I am the light shining in darkness. You all are indeed the light shining through darkness. Even with little face-to-face time for teaching in Form 4, you all have beamed through the challenges of online learning to complete Form 5. To all of you who kept the torch blazing up to this day, hats off to you. Graduates, you have made it thus far with your teachers' help, knowledge, and support, and most of all, because of God's grace and wisdom within you all. The pandemic didn't make it easy, but you all let that fire inside you burst forth like a beam of light, and you all kept shining to the end. I take this opportunity to wish you, the graduating class of 2021, all the best in your future endeavors. Each of you are strong and capable of doing anything you set your mind to do. I congratulate you all. I say thanks to your parents, principals, teachers, and friends who stood with you all through these trying times. Your guidance counselor and social worker, and your family members who were there. May God continue to shine his light through you, and may you all keep shining through the darkness. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Hi everyone, my name is Jameson Riggs. Greetings to the principal, staff, students, parents, to the Guayaguayari Secondary graduating class of 2021. Congratulations. I am the light shining through darkness. You have come to the end of a journey, but you just got started. I want you to remember that birds of a feather flock together. If you run around with losers, you will end up a loser. Unconsciously, you will pick up the habits of losers. You will pick up their attitude. And most importantly, the way that losers think about life. When you begin to look at your life and what you want to become, align yourself with positive people. Align yourself with people who can encourage you, people who can empower you, people who can help you to do better things in life. If you want to become a teacher, align yourself with teachers. If you want to become a businessman or a businesswoman, align yourself with persons involved in business. But it is always going to be hard work. You have to push yourself. You have to align yourself with people who are constantly reaching for higher ground in life. You want to be at the top. The bottom is overcrowded. It doesn't take any effort to be a loser. Somewhere you have to be able to say, let's do this. Come on, push yourself. You are your biggest enemy. As you look towards being a shining light, shining through darkness, as you begin to think towards what you want to become in life, who you want to be in life, what do you need to do to reach where you want to reach in life. Look at where you want to go, the kind of person that you want to be in life. It makes sense that you change your pattern. You find the right strategy, encourage good behavior, and pursue greatness. Look at your plan. Be a light in this world, shining through darkness. All the best. Thank you. Godspeed.
We have reached a very, very important and exciting segment in our graduation ceremony. Are you ready? All right, let's go. Our special award segment 2021 has been designated to highlight some students who shone extra brightly in various categories. Kicking things off is the Citizenship Award. The recipient of the Citizenship Award is Victoria Felice. Victoria has had a positive attitude towards her classmates, teachers, school, and the community. Her demonstration of civic responsibility has been remarkable. Next, we have the Principal's Award. The recipient of the Principal's Award is Olisha Pierre. Olisha is very well known for her optimism and enthusiasm. She is an exemplary student with excellent leadership qualities who has demonstrated true loyalty to her school. Following is the Dean's Award. We have two recipients of these awards, and they go to Anthony Joseph and Ashley Gomez. Anthony and Ashley have both demonstrated a high level of discipline and mannerism. Their morals and values are truly exceptional. And finally, our honored roll of valedictorian from the graduating class of 2021 is Jadali Sagar. Jadali's impressive academic profile has evidently demonstrated her diligence and commitment towards her studies. Additionally, her involvement in extracurricular activities has been commendable. To all recipients of special awards, continue to shine even brighter than you are shining right now. Keep reaching for higher stars. Congratulations and congratulations.
A pleasant day to all on our virtual graduation day. Welcome to our principal, teachers, the staff of our lovely school, parents, invited guests, and my fellow classmates of the graduating class of 2021. I am humbled and honored to be representing my class as the valedictorian on the most memorable day. Thank you all for giving me this opportunity. I am tasked with revealing the journey of our class from darkness into the light. Not literal darkness and light, but the challenges we endure during our time at school up to this day. Our class, the class of 2021, started our journey in September of 2016. We were a group of children from different backgrounds and very young in our lives. Now we are about to choose our careers with big dreams ahead. The past 5 years were a roller coaster ride from one of the best sports days in 2017 academic year to a successful cricket season in 2019 to 2020. We have seen principals come and go, friends leaving, some joining. Then the most devastating event in our era, the COVID-19 pandemic. This caused major panic and resulted in the new norm. Social distancing, wearing masks, and virtual schooling. This was very challenging as this had a direct impact on our preparation for CSEC. Online schooling, stay at home, virtual meeting, and no social activities. Our entire lives had to be adjusted, but the class of 2021 did just that. With the help of our dedicated staff and teachers, we were able to weather this pandemic. Some teachers went over and beyond, even teaching out of school hours and on weekends to ensure our work was covered. Some teachers became more than teachers. They became friends and mentors. We would miss our dear teachers greatly. I am sure that we would have never envisioned our time at Guayaguari Secondary School to end like this. To my fellow classmates, let us continue to be that light in all we do. Wherever life journey takes us, be the light that brightens the darkness of the world around us. Remember, for metal to be as strong as it is, metal has to endure intense heat and treatment prior to it being able to support two bridges and buildings. Trials in life makes us stronger and helps us to deal with challenges if at times we fall. Pick ourselves up and learn from our mistakes. All of us may struggle at some point during our life, but tough times can make us stronger. Always have the courage to continue. Focus on being the light, beaming into success, and in the process, learn who you truly are. Once again, to our teachers, words cannot express our gratitude and appreciation for what you taught us, both academically and morally. These would be engraven in our hearts and minds for years to come. My fellow class of 2021, we did it.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites the candle, and makes his home. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world, take your candle, go light your world. Frustrated brother, see how he's tried to light his own candle some other way. See now your sister. she's been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lonely, the tired and worn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. 'Cause we're a family
whose hearts are blazing.
Our hearts are blazing.
Let's raise our candles.
Let's light up the sky. Pray to our Father
in the name of Jesus.
In His name.
Make us a beacon
in darkest times. So carry your candle.
Run to the
darkest places.
Seek out the hopeless,
the confused and torn.
Hold out your candle.
Hold out your candle
for all to
for
see
everyone
it.
To see.
Take
your candle and go light your go and light, light your world.
Hearty outpouring of blessings upon you on your graduation event. I greet you with exuberance, for this is indeed a significant rite of passage. Get ignited and go light your world. I was very much taken with joy at your theme, which deals with light. And I want you to know that there is a light inside of each one of you. Your role, your purpose is to make sure to be very certain that all that marvelous light within you is made manifest. So go light your world. You have to ignite and go light. Your dream, as you contemplate on the significance of today, must take you into your future propelled and excited to go there. So activate, make it active. Stir it up into motion, your dream, with energetic operation so that you can have that internal energy to guide you. Remove, alleviate all fear, because this is what is going to cause your light to go dim. Make sure your light is fully lit at all times. Accentuate it. Make your dream prominent. Make your goals very real and articulate this dream with action. As you contemplate on all you have achieved through school, and as you take a moment to consider the future that is ahead, know for a fact that a lot depends on what decisions you make. And those decisions will keep your light aflame or dim your light, even extinguish your flame. Make sure that excellence and not existence is what controls your motion. You have to understand that the light shines in darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Regardless of what is going on all around, even now at this time, we are having your graduation in this manner where it's basically virtual. And you are hearing my voice and you are seeing me thanks to the technological fascination. I want what I am saying to remain in your mind as a basic foundation. The light within you is able to overpower the darkness that may be around you. And this is based on a scriptural doctrine, you know. You are the light of the world. A town on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither does a person light a lamp and put it under a bowl or under a bed. No, they put it high on a stand so that it can give of its glow to everyone in the house. And so, students, let your light shine so others may see your good work and glorify the Lord. You know, Shakespeare said something very interesting. Shakespeare said, "How far that little candle throws its beams, so shines a good deed in a naughty world." He is saying the same thing. Shakespeare is saying that little candle is able to give off such a glow. That little candle is able to give off such powerful light. So shines a good deed in a dark world. And so we may find ourselves having to shine our light because everything around seems a little grim. But make sure you pump yourself up with faith and with joy and all the positive energy you will need to achieve your dream. The president of New Zealand, Jacinda Ardern, said this: "There have been chinks of light that have shone through even the darkest of times. That light has been our determination, our support for one another, our sense of resolve, and that light has always been more powerful than the most overwhelming darkness." Now that is fascinating stuff. And when I say go light your world, I mean work with everything you've got. God has given you talent. You have now, when your results come out, you have what you have in your hand to take you to the next step, to the next level. Let me tell you something my mother told me when I was waist high. These are my mother's words to me. She said, "There is a light in you, child. God has put it there. You will go far. There's a seat in the university with your name written on it. Work hard. Walk in boldly, shoulders back, chin up. Find your seat and sit in it." I repeat to you those very words. There is a light in you, child. God put it there. And so you have to walk into your purpose, fulfilling the maximum possible. You are not here to exist. You are here to excel. And excellence must be your mantra. I want to tell you that Amanda Gorman, she had the lovely task of speaking at the inauguration of Joe Biden, President Joe Biden's inauguration. So, what did Amanda Gorman say? Amanda Gorman is a girl who, just like you, young and talented, and she wrote her speech. And it is so potent. Her speech begins like this: "When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade?" That is her opening sentence. I ask you the same. When day comes, day is here. When we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? This dimness, let me tell you, where can we find the light? It comes from within. It comes from your relationship with your God. It comes from the fact that you are here to shed light, for glow. Amanda Gorman continues, and I have extracted from her speech. It continues, "And yet the dawn is ours. Before we knew it, somehow we do it." The dawn is yours, my dear students. She continues, "And so we lift our gaze not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be. Benevolent, but bold, fierce, and free. So when day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. I am in love with those words. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. Upon your graduation, students, that's what you do. You step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. And she ends her speech like this. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light. If only we are brave enough to see it. If only we are brave enough to be it. So you need to be brave enough to embrace the light. You need to be brave enough to be the light. And I'm here to tell you, you are not here to exist, you are here to excel. And excellence is surpassing all rivals, obstacles, trials. Go after your dreams and light your world. Have that desire to achieve. Have that desire for good success. Have that desire to light your path in a way that it was never lit before. All that your parents have achieved are fine things, but what you are about to achieve must be better. You must have good success. You must take your family to a higher level. There must be a determination for excellence. And a champion is what you are. A champion is a person who is able to take that light within, all that is marvelous within, and make it manifest. And so I tell you, achieve the dream. Be sure that your light is shining right. Hope is the bedrock. It is a belief that our destiny will not be written for us, but written by us. And for all those who are not content to settle for the world as it is, but have the courage to remake the world as it should be. Barack Obama said that, and let me tell you, that's exactly what he did. He realized there was a light within him and he wanted that to shine to change the world. He walked on a platform boldly and he said, yes, we can. Three very simple words, and Barack Obama won the US election with that. You can win your dream with those words. Yes, we can. Never underestimate the power of a dream. Yes? Today I want to leave you with the fact that your light is going to overpower every dimness you may face, every dark moment you may encounter, because there is a force behind and an energy within that light. You are not to accept, you are to accelerate. You are not to exist, you are to excel. So make that internal pledge today. Today is such a grand day, being the event of your graduation exercise, that you will take this with you as you approach everything in life. You are not here to exist. You are here to excel. You are not here to cope. You are here to conquer. And so, let your light so shine that men may see your good works and glorify your God.
Guayaguari Secondary School Graduating Class of 2021 Subject Awards, where dedication is rewarded. These students were chosen based on their discipline, regularity, and excellence in understanding practical and theoretical components of each subject area. For the Subject Award of Biology, we have Anthony Joseph. For chemistry, Victoria Valis. Data operations, Jada Lee Saga. Food and nutrition, Shaquila Baker Williams. Integrated science, Jada Lee Saga. We have two awardees in the area of mathematics, Anthony Joseph and Maria Lafourcade. Mechanical Engineering Technology, Alicia Pear. Music, Shaquilla Baker Williams. Principles of Business, Josiah Riggs. Social Studies, Jada Lisaga. Spanish, Victoria Velis. Theater Arts, Jada Lisaga. Visual Arts, Mark Muhammad. Congratulations to all awardees.
Always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. Always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy, but so wish you love, I wish you love. For you the world just opens.